Dr. Sandhya Krishnan, Senior Consultant in Infertility at IMAkerala, Calicut. I will be talking to you about when to go for in vitro fertilization or ICSI, intracytoplasmic sperm injection treatment. So this is a common question asked by many couples who are who have been struggling to have a child, and this has to be made aware among the infertile couple so that the treatment can be taken at a proper age and time. So let us go to what are the causes where we can directly go for in vitro fertilization or ICSI treatment. So the first I will be talking to you about male factor, that is severe male factor, where direct ICSI is needed. Like when the semen analysis shows a persistently low sperm count below 10 million per ml even after taking medicines for a long time, or when the post-wash sperm count, that is when you are going for intrauterine insemination, the andrologist says that your post-wash sperm count is less than 5 million per ml, or when there is azoospermia, that is the sperms are not at all coming into the semen sample, and which could be due to an obstruction like bilateral absence of vas deferens, or due to non-obstruction when the count is so low or the synthesis of the sperms is so low that it is not coming into the semen sample. Here actually in azoospermia we need to extract the sperms by surgical sperm retrieval, and these sperms are not capable of fertilizing the eggs unless we do ICSI, that is intracytoplasmic sperm injection with them. The next cause is a tubal factor, where there is an obvious block of the tubes in the tube patency test, and it has been proven laparoscopically that it is not correctable. Also in couples where the female gives a history of pelvic inflammatory disease or severe endometriosis, in which the tubal patency and tubal motility is hindered. Also in patients where the tube patency test has shown a tubal block, but this has been corrected surgically by laparoscopy, but the couple has failed to conceive 1 year after the laparoscopic correction of the tubes. So this means that even though the tubes are patent, the tubes are not functioning properly. Also in couples who give a history of a bilateral tubal ectopic in the past, it's an obvious indication that the tubes are not functioning properly. So the we have spoken about the male factor and the tubal factor. So the next is the ovarian cause, in which resistant polycystic ovarian disease, which is not responding to other treatments, or even though responding, the couple is not conceiving. Also in severe endometriosis or bilateral endometriotic cyst, and diminishing ovarian reserve, which usually occurs after the age of 35 years, but now because of environmental factors, the age of diminishing ovarian reserve has also reduced, and it which has to be confirmed even in the first visit itself, and told to the couple that the ovarian reserve is towards the lower side. So the tubal factor, the male factor, the ovarian factor, and also the multiple factors, like the female has a small problem with ovulation and the male factor is not also very good. In those cases when there are multiple causes for infertility and the couple is not conceiving with smaller treatments, like they have undergone 3 to 4 cycles of IUI, they have been trying naturally also since 5 to 7 years, and that those cases also better to go for IVF. And cases where there has been a history of some surgery, pelvic surgery, like ovarian surgery or tubal surgery, those patients also should be cautious and should go for IVF if the smaller treatments are not feasible. Also, why we are asking the couples to go for IVF at an earlier stage is because the way the natural conception reduces with age in females, the success rate of IVF also reduces with age. So to have a rough idea, I can tell you that this 40% success rate in IVF that is quoted throughout the world is for couples where the female is less than 35 years of age. Now beyond 35 to 38 years, this success rate reduces to 30%, and 30 to 40 years it again reduces to 20%, 40 to 42 years this again reduces to 5 to 10%, and beyond 42 years it's just 2%. So that's why when with advancing age we should try to even more conceive earlier, and if not possible by natural methods, better to go for IVF or ICSI. So the last but not the least, when the couple is having recurrent miscarriage, and which is because of chromosomal problem with the couple or with the embryo that is forming, it is better to go for IVF and ICSI treatment, in which we can go for a pre-implantation genetic diagnosis and confirm the chromosomal health of the embryo and put a genetically normal embryo into the uterus so that the pregnancy loss does not happen because of this reason. We have gone through the tubal factor, the male factor, the ovarian factor, the unexplained factor, multiple factor, diminishing ovarian reserve with advancing age, and recurrent pregnancy loss due to chromosomal causes as the indications for going for in vitro fertilization or intracytoplasmic sperm injection. This awareness is very important, because for a success in IVF, we need to take the treatment at a proper age and at the right time.